Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Bestinslot, and we are back playing Zoo Tycoon 2. And today, instead of doing what I said we were going to do and working on the aquatic area, because it does really quite badly need it, we are going to work on the Dominus Rex, because it has popped up, and that seems like something to take advantage of, because it never bloody pops up. I've been waiting a very long time for this little bugger, and he's finally here, so we are going to work on him instead. As soon as I clean the Gemsbok exhibit. So this is actually going to be the final exhibit. The first time we've done that. Oh my god, I've got so many animals in this exhibit. This is going to be the final exhibit for the rainforest kind of region, I believe. Oh, hello. Oh my god, what? A private benefactor has approached our zoo and would like to make an anonymous transaction. They have an animal available. They refuse it. I'm just going to learn English, one sec. They have an animal available, but they refuse to disclose what species. They've implied that it is a rare species, but won't provide a guarantee. They do guarantee that this is a legal transaction. They are offering the animal to you for their cost of 16,000. Do I trust the benefactor? I've got enough cash. I'm not poor. I'm not loaded either. At the end of the day, right, we're doing challenge mode so we can do daft stuff like this. And the Indominus Rex is oddly cheap. So, you bugger. Unfortunately, the anonymous benefactor did not accurately represent the facts. While you have received a healthy animal, it is not as exclusive as was implied, and it is likely that you have overpaid. However, the animal is certainly better off in your care than in the hands of the unscrupulous benefactor, and your guests will certainly enjoy the new addition. Totally worth it. I saved an animal's life, sort of. What is it? What is it? Anyone want to play some bets? It's obviously a land creature. It's a beaver! Cool! Oh no, there's going to be comments. There's going to be so many comments. Right. Now, the problem with the beaver is it doesn't fit anywhere. The Indominus Rex doesn't need as much. Can I fit both in here? I must be able to fit both in here. Let's put the path in, because there's going to have to be a path around the bottom or sides of this exhibit. Oh, look at that curve. That is beautiful. That is what memories are made of. Write home and tell your parents, kids. The curve is here. Ah, 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 no, it's so close to being perfect. There we go. Okay, I should be able to actually delete that bit. Oh, it's just beautiful. It's stunning. Right, can I fit a beaver exhibit and an Indominus Rex exhibit in this bit? I really want to do the beaver exhibit because it's a wetlands exhibit and we don't have one in the game. And I don't really... The problem is I don't want to cut into the alpine because... Tell you what, we might just cut into this one instead. If we put the beaver here... Yeah, that's a better idea. I don't want to cut into the alpine exhibit, but I want the Indominus Rex to have a really big, showy exhibit because it's an Indominus Rex at the end of the day. But we can't cut into this one because the safari one is already kind of cutting into it with the giant ground sloths. So... Yeah... Here I come to clean the poop. This has really grown on me, this little sort of ducked down exhibit. Right, let's do what we said. We're going to work on the Indominus and then we're going to do a wetlands exhibit, which is quite exciting for me as well because I really wanted something swampy. And all my exhibits up here, 4 out of 5, are this bloody tropical rainforest. Why are you hungry? Did I not give you food? Thinking about it, no, I did put food in. Maybe I just haven't replenished it. There you go, have some meat. I'm going to put a trough in. There we go. That should sort it for a while. Something is blocking the meat. Yeah, I've been there, my friend. Okay, Indominus Rex. Right, what do I need for you? I'm assuming... Apparently low iron bar fence will work. I feel it's a bad idea. I also feel I'm definitely going to do it and see what happens, basically. I'm trying to think of a way we can make it an exciting exhibit. What I'm thinking is maybe the path comes up a little bit and curves here, and then the exhibit curves around that path, so you can kind of like stand in the middle of the exhibit, kind of like what we had down here where people were standing at the sides. And then, just thinking, what I'm thinking, and that's going to seem daft, but what if we made it a wall instead? No, we can't. We can't use the. I like the idea of using the. No, we can do that. I think if we have that right, let me just put this in. It's gonna waste. Oh, hello. You are approached by a scientific journal writing an educational article about even-toed ungulates. They want 3 specific pictures and of a camel, a gemsbok. No. All I'm thinking, right, is that this is an awesome way to view an Indominus Rex, like this. So I'm kind of thinking of a, it'll go in, and this bit here will be circled by this. This will be circled by the tank. Because if he's not going to break out of a low iron bar fence, he's probably not going to break out of that either. And so you'll be able to walk down the path here. Maybe I'll put it a little bit lower. You'll be able to walk on the outside as well, with normal fencing. But you'll walk down here, and there'll be acrylic fencing here. So it'll be like you're surrounded by the Indominus Rex. Yeah, we're going to do that. That's a cool idea. Okay, so I need to put the path in at approximately the halfway point. I want it to be there and there. No, there and there. One more. Oh, I don't know. That'll do. That looks too central. There. So that's going to go. I don't want it to go too far because I don't want to use up all the exhibit room. I know that looks a little daft, but it'll make sense. Well, then. Look, right, feces gone everywhere. No more feces. No more feces for anybody. Because you keep complaining about it. Now you get no feces. How do you feel? I knew as soon as I clicked that I was going to fall in the bloody non-existent koi pond. It is just a weird little pond. Many children are going to fall in there, which I'm okay with. Right, so let's test this. Is that going to be far enough? If that's all acrylic, I think we can push this out a little bit further. Just by 1 or 2. And then I want to delete down the middle. Whoa, not like that. I want it to be like a walkway, so you'd walk through and back around. It's going to look cool. It's going to be cool. If it works, there's every chance the Indominus is going to break out of this with absolutely no problems whatsoever. But we've got to have faith, folks. We've got to have faith. How long do bloody mantas live? These guys have been here since the start of the game. Manta 1 is right there. The very first creature. Manta 1 deserves a name. Manto. Dr. Mantis Toboggan. Mantis Toboggan. Is that how you spell toboggan? Mantis Toboggan. Reference. Moving on. I think that's going to be okay. And because we're doing it like this, I'm going to use the dino fence for the rest of it. Just. Oh, okay. Huh. I'm not going to have I'm not going to have half of these creatures. I think we're pretty much out of challenge mode, oddly enough. It's kind of like, if a really cool challenge comes up, we'll do it, but I've got the next 2 exhibits kind of planned irrespective of challenge mode, you know? I'd like to actually work on them, but crap keeps coming up. Right, so we're going to go dinosaur gate, and that's going to start, well, there, I suppose. No, not there, there, right. What's this little bit here? I'll put a thing there, that's fine. That's gonna go up there. I want some fence coming along here, so maybe we can go like. I just want it to look dramatic. And vaguely symmetrical. Which it does, it kind of looks like a fortress, which is pretty cool. And then, I think this will work. I don't see any reason it wouldn't. Actually, I see quite a lot of reasons this would definitely not work. This is pretty much what they tried to do in bloody Jurassic World, and we know how that went. Why would you want an opaque tank wall? I suppose, okay. Can I curve you? Yes, look at it, it's beautiful. It's actually not that beautiful, and we can make it more beautiful. I have a horrible suspicion this isn't going to work, but I think it's worth a try, you know? Okay. Okay, so let's have a look what that's going to look like. For God's sake. Meow. Boop. First of all, you'd see that and you'd think, right, that's pretty cool. That's pretty dramatic looking, you know? The end of this region, I'm going to have to flatten that maybe. Hello, child. You're walking along. You see the other exhibits in the distance, but you are tempted in. But that is going to be so cool if it works. There's a child! There's a child in the Indominus Rex paddock! No, you're not leaving the zoo, you're stuck. I don't know how you haven't noticed that yet. Bloody kids. Alright. Let's put this together. So it's already the right thing, but I just want a bit of dirt in there. I wonder why they've made him so cheap. Eh, it doesn't matter. Where would I be if I was water? I'm thinking, kind of like what I was going to do for the otter exhibit. And okay, it's not an otter. It's an Indominus Rex, it's not really the same thing, but I'm thinking like water that just goes... like that. Whoopsie daisy. I'm just a little worried it's going to limit the room too much, but if I do it in one big sweep... Nope, that's stupid. I can get rid of it all easily as well. Okay. Huh. Oh, the manatee! I don't... But... I promise we'll start doing challenges again, because it's a little daft that I'm skipping them, because that's kind of the point of this. But the Indominus Rex has to be the priority, just for this video. Super Giant Warthog. Super Giant Warthog. That is such a cool superhero name. I wonder if I put a gate in here, will my zookeepers be able to get in and out? I'm going to try it, because it's kind of a pain at the moment. I'll give them a go. If they can do it, they can do it. If they can't, they can't. Let's just get this bloody exhibit done. Right, where do I want the water? Maybe just this back bit, where this sticks out a little bit. A little pond region at the back. Yeah, that's fine. Shelter. Okay. Oddly enough, it's quite a big exhibit, but there's no room. Some trees. We're going to have lots of trees. Because again, I know I keep doing that, the lots of trees thing. I kind of have a thing for trees all of a sudden. Considering I usually hate trees, which is really weird. What you do is you do like this, right? And that looks excessive, right? It's too much water. But then we go into this and we kind of just dig into it a little bit. Because all I want is a small stream that kind of gets smaller. So I want it to start off fairly thick and then dwindle down, you know? Ooh, not like that though. Yeah. And a little, yeah. And a little bit over here as well, just to... Because I feel this is what it would be like, you know, you'd have little pockets, little bits in the ground where it's gone down and you'd have this kind of region. We're gonna get the carcasses because that's just, you know, it's a bloody Indominus Rex. And we're going to get a live food lizard. We're going to get one of these as well. Which I'd love to put in this corner because I think it's going to fit really well, but it's not going to let me. Okay, let's just... It's an art form, ladies and gentlemen. It's an absolute art form, this game. You think I'm joking, but I'm really not. You have to feel it, you know? You have to feel the exhibits. That's a bit far. Am I going to be able to cut into that? Yeah. Okay, cool. Right. Some beef shanks. What else have we got? I don't really want to put this in. I really want it to look as natural as possible, this one. So bones, live food lizards, stuff like that. We'll put some bones over. Yeah, some bones outside the entrance to The Home. Oh my god. Marine show. I mean, I am planning to do a show area. I think I'm actually going to put it in the aquatic region instead of the snowy bit. The snowy bit's just going to be cool and snowy, which is fine. So, we could accept it. We're going to do it at some point. Why not have the challenge? Yeah. It gives us something to work on that's in that region as well, which is always a pretty good idea. Right, yeah. So what I was doing. There's some meat and bones outside the exhibit. Well, it's home. It looks like they've been feasting. They are going to need more toys, so we'll put some lizards knocking about. Food-wise, we're going to have the carcasses. Trees, we'll do in a second. I was working on rocks, wasn't I? Art form, ladies and gentlemen. Art form. I want it to look like a little rocky cavern, kind of nestled away. I'm thinking this might work. Just putting it on a little raised hill as well. Or the opposite. Do we maybe valley it? Or ditch? Oh, God. Okay, apparently I'm not... we can do this. Create a little bit of variance in the exhibit. Put a bit of a hill in, say, somewhere. God knows where. We'll find somewhere. Okay, hills are... cliffs are weird. Nobody likes cliffs. We like hills. Maybe a little excessive. Yeah, just it looks a little bit more. I don't know, interesting. All right. I was gonna say we can just hire another guy, but I'm really, really poor. Why am I so poor? Oh, we spent 16,000 on a bloody. My God, this is filthy. We spent 16,000 on a beaver, didn't we? Because we're clever. Oh, hello, beautiful. Don't think I don't see you there. And you in the corner, but we'll leave you. We need to get this exhibit done. Mastodon, yeah, I'm excited about that as well. Trees. Trees are important. That's a Gemsbok. All of these are Gemsbok trees. Every single one of them. I was thinking, this does not look like a tropical rainforest. Because I'm an idiot. Indominus. Trees, that's more like it. What's the biggest one? I don't think I don't see you there, Gemsbok tree. I know you're there. The idea is, it's kind of like... okay, they're not going to be able to move. There's so many bloody trees. But that's kind of the point. That, I'm going to have to flatten that out. It's like in the film. It's like in... Jurassic World. And you're looking into the exhibit, you know. You're looking through the trees to try to spot the Indominus Rex as it stalks around. It looks a little small because of the amount of trees, but it is bigger than it looks. A sentence she should all get used to saying, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, God in heaven, right. Smooth. Or flatten, actually. Small flatten. Yeah, we're going to have to do that. And that looks pretty good, right? Bingo. Bango. Job's a good one. They're not going to move, are they? Do you not move? Are you broken? Are you irrevocably broken? You look stupid now that I look at you in person. I mean, it looks really cool. The idea is phenomenal, and they've gone and ruined it by just sitting there stupidly. Grumble, grumble, bloody grumble. Right. And this idea is so cool. It really is. And they've screwed it up. Are they at least happy enough for me to... Right, there they go. Bye-bye, chaps. The solution to this problem... Because this is a dramatic exhibit. It demands something exciting. You know, it demands something cool. So what we need to do, I suppose, is browse through until we find an exciting... We're going to put the hippo with the sloth thing. Not sloth. The hippo with the... What did I get? I'm amazing. We're going to put the hippo with the beaver. That's going to be a cool exhibit. That's going to go down there somewhere. We're looking for... What's that? And the Nile monitor. Why not? But we're looking for anything that will go in the rainforest. I'm hoping the T-Rex might step in and do it for me. Or we could put some bears. Or gorillas. No. We don't need gorillas because we've already got the bloody... I mean, I could put something else. Let's just find something cool. What do we want? This is what matters. What do we want in the exhibit? Because I can always just change the basal, the ground, to something else. And just kind of change the whole exhibit. I'd be okay with that idea. But it has to be something... It feels like it should be a carnivore. You know? And the thing is, right, I'm freaking out about all these creatures we're not going to see. Because at some point, we're going to run out of room. And we're not that far from that point, folks. We are definitely getting there. But the thing is... we're going freeform after this. So every single creature we possibly miss, we can just add anyway, you know? With no limitations. So it's not really something to worry about. And yet I find myself consistently worried about it. Meow. This is going to be the coolest exhibit so far. Just need to find something deserving of it. Cave lion. That is going to go in the tundra zone, though. It'd be very cool about it. We could put the Deinosuchus in here. That wouldn't be a bad shout. I'd have to... No. I love the idea we've got for the Deinosuchus exhibit. I really want this more swampy kind of feel to it. Like, where it's just water absolutely everywhere, you know? Don't want gorillas just because we've got Gigantopithecus. Let's see what the time... If the T-Rex fits, we'll put it in. I'm slightly worried because the T-Rex is actually a creature from the game that it will break the tank walls. Plus, where the hell is the creature that I added? Where do you live? It's going to be the T-Rex. We're obviously not going to spend 80 grand on the T-Rex. And I'm going to try to find a better skin for it online. I'll go do that after this episode. But that's going to be two T-Rexes. Okay. Plan is in action. I apologize that we kind of spent this whole episode doing that and it turned out to be utterly useless. There's really no other way to describe it. But it will be worth it eventually. Put some benches in. I worry that people are going to collapse on me. A very common fear I have. That's not even slightly symmetrical. Benches. Thank God there isn't a limit in benches like there is in JPOG. I would have run out a very long time ago. I was meant to use jungle benches. Oopsie daisy. Yeah, so we're going to put a couple of T-Rexes in there, because they'll fit everything we already have, you know? I shouldn't have to change anything, I don't think. Yeah, everything's the same. Put loads of live lizards roaming about. Very cool. Yeah, okay, so next episode, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to do our little thing in the bottom. I'm so poor, by the way. Next episode, we'll go do our thing in the bottom right corner where we get a couple of T-Rexes from the fossils. And once that's done, we'll try and do like a bumper episode. So we'll do that and we'll also try to do the hippo slash... What did I get? Mastodon. Hippo slash beaver exhibit, which is going to be the last of our forest exhibits, and that is going to go here. And then that zone will be done. Bottom right will be basically done, and we can start working on the Alpine region, and we can start working on this big central tank over here as well, which is going to be really, really cool. I am also going to AFK for quite a while just to make sure I have some cash, and also because we need 9 more pieces of Dinosuchus to actually do any of those plans. Thank you very much for joining me as per usual. I shall see you lovely folks then. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye.